Hi everyone, my name is Naomi and I'm a global U-grader from the 2016-2017 cohort. This is real-time editing Naomi because I didn't like the intro that I did. I did try to keep the same shirt, but my face and my hair is totally different. But that doesn't matter. Today's video is going to be about my experience as an exchange student in the United States. And I have a special guest to share her experience as well. And I'm gonna let her introduce herself.
My name is Nicole, and I am Naomi's friend. So I'm Filipino. I was assigned to attend the University of Mississippi. It was a very unique and different experience, as you can imagine, because it's like the Deep South, right?
So I went to the Western Washington University.
It is located in the Pacific Northwest, so it rained a lot.
The air was so crisp. Just thinking about your campus, how did it differ from where you came from? And what did you really like about it?
Well, in the Philippines, like a lot of the campuses are very close. They have like high walls around them. It's not really open for security reasons, you know. It's built that way for good reason, but obviously in the US, it's much more open. There are a lot more facilities. There are gyms. There are huge cafeterias. I mean, the architecture in itself is very different from that of Asia, right? The brick walls.
Like mine and yours.
Yeah, it's a very walkable campus as compared to like the campus that I'm used to. Yeah, like what you said, it's more fresh. You are able to breathe. There's less pollution, which is always great. I was really lucky to experience Ole Miss during springtime.
Definitely, because then you also get to hang out outdoors a bit more. So at my university, it was a mixture of like the modern architecture and the old rustic buildings. It was very green. They had a lot of pine trees and certain parts of the campus, right? When you are walking there alone, it actually feels kind of creepy.
Oh, yeah. There were some parts on campus that were like just forests.
Yes.
And I was like, where am I? Yeah.
Like dangerous.
Yeah. I remember like exploring that area before getting a SIM card, so I didn't have internet. I really thought I was lost, so I was a bit scared, but I wasn't alone that time. But we were both scared and we just tried looking for help, and eventually we found a way out. Yeah, shout out to Luis.
I also agree with you, it's much more open. Like in Malaysia, this is very closed. Whenever you want to enter, you always have to like register, show an ID, and have a reason to go in. In the university that I went to, and similar as yours, anyone could access. Nice. I feel like in a way, it also kind of symbolizes like the openness to share information. So like you can just go to their library and like, you know, study there.
I really love the libraries like in the US. I love how it's very conducive for learning. That's something that I wish we had more of in the Philippines, because we don't really have public libraries, or like school libraries would only be like really small. But then the selection in these libraries, wow, it's like really amazing. Like I could spend hours just in the library, and you know, that's really how I would spend my days, because I loved how it felt inside, if that makes sense.
And it's like well facilitated. They have many nooks and crannies for you, so like you don't have to join the crowd. I don't really like studying in the library in general, so I've never studied in the library when I was in Malaysia. But when I went there, I actually went to study in the library. That's like a miracle.
Did you have like cafes inside also? Like our libraries had like cafes also.
We don't have a cafe inside, but we have it like outside, so you can just buy it and go inside.
Did you live on campus?
Yeah, I did. The one that I stayed at, they didn't specifically say it, but it feels like it's meant for international students. So they also have Americans living there, but most of the international students on campus would be living in that building.
Yeah, same, actually. Like the residence hall that I was in was built for foreign students, I think. I didn't see any Americans except for the, what do you call them?
The RAs?
Yeah, the RAs. Yeah, they were the only Americans there. Yeah. I didn't have a roommate, by the way, so...
Like, from the get-go, like, it is a room for just one person, or you just never had someone come in?
She never came in. She moved in with somebody else, but she paid for that room, so that's why her name is still on it.
So is it, like, a suite, or is it, like, a room?
A room, and I had, like, a microwave, a fridge, and a bathroom. Pretty standard. We had a shared kitchen, though, but I didn't have to use the kitchen. We had access to the meals, right? We had a meal plan. Did you have that?
Yes, I love the meal plan.
This unlimited swipe. Yeah.
So mine is like a suite. When we walk in, there is like the living area, like a small living area. There's a tiny kitchen and the bathroom, which is shared. And then we go left or right into our rooms.
Wow. So that's huge. That's huge.
I wouldn't call it huge, but it's big. At least there's not too many people and we have our privacy because there's only four people, right? There were two Americans and one Fijian.
I kind of wonder like what it would be like if I did live with someone. I think that's also how I learned how to be like truly independent because that was really my first time living alone. So far away from home and alone.
Speaking of your meal plans, like how was it? Like the one that I got was like the most expensive meal plan. So we had unlimited meals. So we can swipe as many times. That's so awesome, right? I could eat as much as I want. Not even think about the money.
We had that. So we had access to like the buffets during breakfast, lunch, and dinner. But then we also had like an allowance of $10.
Similar. Yep. So pretty standard, I guess.
Yeah, maybe. I think so. That's the most expensive, the bougie plan, yes. I guess. So I would use the cash in the card to buy meals at a bagel shop. So that was my go-to place, a bagel shop, a bagel and coffee shop. I miss it though. I miss the people working there. They would always give me free coffee.
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah.
Do you have Starbucks on campus?
Yeah, inside the library.
I'm Starbucks on campus, and we get to use the dining dollars.
How much did you have? Because like Starbucks is from Washington, right?
I think we had two. Because like other than Starbucks, we also had another like local one. I don't remember what it's called. About four or slightly more cafes on campus.
Wow. We had Einstein Brothers and Starbucks. We had Cane's also, the fast food chain, the chicken. Maybe this is a southern thing. I'm not sure. Steak and Shake. I think.
Let me. Oh, that sounds so good. We had like Panda Express, which I never ate because it's like fake Chinese food.
Oh, that's true. We didn't have Panda Express. I didn't really get a lot of Asian food when I was in Mississippi. No.
So let's talk academics. So what do you think was like very different for you?
It was very homework heavy because like in the Philippines, we had homework, but it wasn't really that intense. And by intense, I mean like it really needed 100% pure effort on your part. Like the preparation for homeworks were as stressful as an actual exam. So I treated homeworks like they were like my final exam. I think that they also made up like a big percentage of our grades.
Yes, it did. It's a completely different system because in Malaysia, we'll have two lectures per week and one tutorial. A tutorial is where you do your discussions. But in the US, there was only one. It's more like a classroom session and then you just debate, you discuss in there. I felt that that was actually really nice because it didn't take up too much of my time going to class. But I agree with you, it's very homework heavy. Every homework is graded and it contributes to your final exams, right? So that your final exam is only like maybe 20 or even 30%. By then, I was already in my third year at university. So I took, say, like first and second year courses that I kind of already passed. You guys went for like one semester, right? I went for two quarters because my university went by quarters. Mm-hmm. So in total, I had eight courses.
I had five courses.
Did you exceed the minimum hours?
I think I did. I think the minimum was 12. Yep. And I got 15. 12. I got 15. So I wanted the full experience. I don't know what I was doing. No, I should have gotten 12. And I decided to take like the capstone courses, the hardest courses in a subject. Like I got the capstone course in finance and in operations, you know, and yeah, I did that to myself. It was very challenging because I thought that like the stuff that I learned in the Philippines would lighten the load. I was in my last year of university, so I thought that I knew enough to survive, you know, the academic life in the US, but I was dead wrong. I really had to put in the effort. It was not the nicest experience. It was very humbling, though. It was a very humbling experience, that I can say.
Do you think the intensity of us Asians studying back in our home country, do you think it's slightly easier when studying in the US? Because that's actually how I felt.
Yes, definitely. Right? Definitely. I think we have
a harder time.
I think so. And we have a different work ethic. I think we are used to the pressures.
Yes.
You know, bestowed upon us. Like, there are expectations to be met. It's a different approach in the US, I would say. Yes. I think it's more coming from a cultural perspective more than anything.
Yep. I felt more relaxed there. It's more about learning. I'm not just memorizing everything to just vomit it out in the final exams. I'm really there to just learn and understand. The lecturers or the professors, they're really willing to help, and their doors are always open.
That's actually one thing that I was really surprised about also, that they had hours for students. Like, they would allot time to actually help
talk
you.
Talk to you.
Yeah, talk to you and be like, hey, okay, this, to clarify things. Because, like, in the Philippines, I think the professors are a bit unapproachable. Like, same. Most.
Girl, yeah, I think it's an Asian thing. They are there to help, but they don't give you the approachable vibes.
Like, you'd always have to go out of your way to try to look for your professor and try to find their free time. But in the States, there's actually, you know,
proper
a fixed
hours.
Time schedule where you could actually go to their office and say, hey, professor, I need help with my homework. I didn't really understand the lecture, which I think is very helpful and very encouraging also. It actually encouraged me a lot to learn more and to actually listen more intently. It made me respect them more as, you know, teachers.
I think that is the point of learning. You shouldn't be pressured to learn. One of my favorite memories is definitely, you know, we had to take a US studies course, right? I took the American Indian studies.
Wow, that's so interesting.
Yeah, it's so foreign to me. Like, I know close to nothing. I only know Pocahontas before that. It's a history class, right? About their culture and where they came from. Being a native himself, he was able to give us a lot of stories so we can, you know, imagine how it really is. He even brought us to a conservation school.
Oh, wow, there was a field trip?
Yes. He's like, okay, next week we're going on a field trip to the conservation school. It was a really good experience. It's not just hearing him and like it's theoretical. You actually experience it. And he would also bring like king salmon sandwich to class. Food in class? I'm sold.
Small break in between the 4 hours?
Yeah, there's break maybe like after 1 hour or after 1.5 hours. And he doesn't always teach like the entire 4 hours because it's really late too. It was 6 to 10.
PM?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Okay, I see.
Yeah, it was a struggle to get to class, but because it was so interesting that it motivated me to go. But the first class was really demotivating because it was an introduction class where he passed around an eagle feather. Whenever you have the feather, you have to introduce yourself and say a random fact, something you know about the culture. The good thing is they don't pressure you or they don't embarrass you if you don't know something. But most of my classmates knew, like, say, the mascot name or, like, they use turquoise colored jewelry. But it made me want to go to class because there's so much to learn.
That's really nice. It's a good thing that you got that course, really. Because I think I've heard from most scholars, they got American politics, they got American history, I think you're the first one that took like native history. I took actually American musical theater.
Wow.
Learned about the history, the different forms, and we also had to perform. We had a lot of like solo performances. It was mostly that also.
Solo?
Yeah, solo performances. But what I found the most interesting was learning more about the minstrel shows. So the blackface shows. Because since I was studying in the Deep South, there were a lot of odes to the time during segregation.
Mm-hmm.
So it was very segregation focused. So I've always wanted to learn more about segregation and the history of slavery in the United States. And I think that being in the Deep South gave me that opportunity.
So we're both Asians.
We're both Asian.
How was your experience?
I think a lot of people weren't really that friendly. I mean, it's the South, so what do you expect? But some people thought I was from California for some reason. A lot of people were unsure of my ethnicity. They've never heard of the Philippines also. They just knew I was foreign and not from there, but they wouldn't really go as much as to ask where I was from. Yeah, I didn't really face a lot of discrimination. Oh, but there were some annoying moments actually in the US when they would be surprised to know that I can speak English.
Mind blown, like, guys. Mind blown.
Yeah, and, like, they would like try to talk to you slowly. Like, they would try to use like very basic language because they would be afraid that you wouldn't understand.
They do not do basic.
Yeah, exactly. They would be like, oh, this is a like so-and-so. Do you know what a so-and-so is? I'm like, yeah. oh, wow, your English is so good. Why is it so good? And I'm like, what do you mean? Yeah, so those were some of the annoying moments that I've had. And they,
I think they're very much in the bubble. So they don't really know what's going on the outside. As mm-hmm. opposed to us from the third world country, we have to know what's going on the outside.
That's true.
So that's why we are like more informed and we have to learn the English language in order to survive. It all boils down to that. Funny story, Olivia, my roommate, she came back from winter break. I was just making my Maggi noodles in the mm-hmm. kitchen and she literally put her head like that to peek at me because she was like unsure of what to expect. So I'm like, yeah. Hi, I'm Naomi, your roommate. But now when mm-hmm. looking back, she said it was so funny because she thought that I would know almost zero English. And she was so relieved that I could actually speak English and I was fluent. A common yeah. misconception mm-hmm. that we can't speak English.
Oh, they also asked if like the Philippines had like malls or Wi-Fi.
They do not know how awesome our malls are. It's way better than their malls.
That's true. I mean, it's pretty harmless, but they just don't really know how to express it, I guess.
I mean, we are foreigners. Like,
yeah, that's true, though. That's true.
Well, how about food? Food on campus, food in the US in general. Do you like it? It was like kind of like so-so. What?
I tried Asian food. So I tried having sushi. Not the best sushi I've ever had. Southern food is really good. Soul food.
I like soul food. Really? I think I would like eat out every weekend if I was there.
I actually love grits. Like, I know a lot of people hate
what is grits?
It looks like mashed potatoes, but the consistency is much different. It's like grainy mashed potatoes. It's like mushy. And a lot of people, they don't really like the mouth feel. But I love it.
Do you miss like Asian food though? Like Filipino food? Or the food was like so awesome that it didn't even give you the time to think about it?
Not so much. No, not so much.
Yeah, I didn't really miss Malaysian food as much, but I definitely miss having spices in my food and spicy food. I think it was like my second month in because at the dining hall, it's like buffet style, right? So they have pizzas, they have burgers, salad bar. You know, most of their veggies are salads and like I'm Chinese, right? We eat more like stir-fried vegetables and all that. So that's one that I couldn't get and I couldn't find any chili sauce. Like, not even in the supermarket. They don't sell chili sauce. They only sell, like, ketchup, mustard, mayo, and sriracha. So I got sriracha. Sriracha is not...
Yeah, it's not chili sauce. Yeah, sriracha.
Yeah, it's not chili sauce, but I mean, it's close enough. At least there's the spiciness to it. So I literally bought a bottle of sriracha to bring to the dining hall.
It's, like, the most Asian thing to do, honestly.
At least they have, like, white rice. And I noticed a bit mushy, it's too much water.
I didn't like the rice.
I mean, at least they tried. I'll give them credits for that. Initially, when I was there, they didn't have spoons, like big spoons. You know how like Asians, we use fork and spoon, right?
Yeah.
There, they only had teaspoon for the teacup. I would use the teaspoon and a fork to eat my food. And I think they realized like some Asians were actually doing that. So then they started putting tablespoons there, which I really appreciated. Yeah.
That's great. So they just noticed you using the teaspoon. We also didn't have a lot of spoons and I didn't really want to use the utensils. So there were actually like chopsticks. So I would always use everything. Spaghetti.
I'm surprised they have chopsticks.
Mashed potatoes. That was more for like sanitary reasons. And I wanted to just dispose it like right away. But yes, I was also surprised they had chopsticks because there was an Asian bar. So that's where they would serve like fried rice, Mongolian stir fry or Chinese stir fry. They would also serve their own kinds of like sushi.
Do you have sinks to wash your hand at the dining hall?
I did, but there wasn't soap. So just water.
Which is weird.
Which is strange. Yeah, it's pretty
strange. It's very strange.
Was there soap in the dining room?
No, we didn't even have a sink. I guess because they don't use their hands. I mean, they eat cookies with their hands.
Yeah, they do.
I don't know. And sometimes they don't even wash their hands after using the toilet.
Yeah, I've noticed that. And did you notice?
Then they're going to eat the cookies. Yes, the gap. I don't understand the gap.
Yeah, the gap is like too much. I could like see everything. I've seen things I didn't want to see through those gaps. There are just some things I couldn't unsee anymore. But yeah.
Like, can't they spend a little bit more money on that much of material?
Probably there's a safety reason behind that. Maybe people have been trapped. Maybe.
Or maybe bad things happen before. Like
just to like check if there's actually someone there who needs help.
I don't need help when I'm pooping.
Yeah.
Do you do a lot of traveling when you were there in the US?
I did. But I focused more on the East Coast and the South. Oh, I experienced Mardi Gras in New Orleans.
Wow.
I went to Mardi Gras, and that's something that I'm really happy about. So that was an experience. That was wild. So I went to Tennessee. I went to Alabama, Georgia, Florida, Illinois, New York, DC, Virginia.
That's a lot. Where do you find the time?
Like most of the states, I went there during spring break, I think. It was 2 weeks, yeah. So I spent like 2 days per state, I guess. Because they were all connected.
But how was your experience like? For me, at least, I think it's pretty expensive to travel around. So like from flight tickets to like train, it's pretty pricey.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was pretty expensive. But I think that I lucked out on it. I booked early on. And I had to like look at all the prices beforehand so I could plan where to go. I had to look for cheaper options to go to certain states. I love DC. I really like DC.
It's actually really nice because it's so structured. Everything is clean and just pleasing to the eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And like the museums are free.
Exactly. I was about to say. I love it.
Yep.
I wasn't able to like maximize my stay in DC though. I wish I had more time.
I think I spend most of my time in the West Coast because it's way closer for me. So I've been to Seattle like 3 times. I wish I went there more and explored more. And then during spring break, my sister came over because she had a conference in Texas. So we went to San Francisco and LA together. After she left, I went to Las Vegas for like 2 days, one night. For just one night. It was not enough and I was like rushing it, but at least I got to go to a strip show.
Okay, that's cool. That's cool.
And then I also went to Portland. When I went, it was very gloomy because it's rainy, right, in the Pacific Northwest. It's like a very quirky hipster town.
Oh yeah, I've heard it's pretty hipster down there.
Yep. Washington has a lot of national park. It's full of nature, but I only went to, I think it's called the Olympic National Park. It's like the largest one. I went there over a weekend with my friends because they have cars. We booked like a hostel. We rent out the entire place. So we had our barbecue. Nature there is just on another level.
I wish I had more of those though in Mississippi. I've only gone camping. Hiking, not so much. I've hiked a few times, but not so much. We don't really have a lot of national parks. I think it's also a difference in the climate because like in Mississippi, it's pretty humid because we're close to, I mean.
I can imagine. Washington was humid. Like I felt like I was in Malaysia, kind of, yeah.
True. Mississippi was really hot, actually. The air was really hot. It's very sticky. It's very humid. It felt like Southeast Asia almost, honestly.
So even when you arrive in the winter, it was just hot.
It was freezing when I arrived, or maybe my body was just adjusting, but then it got warm really quick.
Bellingham usually doesn't snow, but right before I arrived it snowed. On one hand, it's great because I actually got to see snow for the first time in my life, but on the other hand, I was not used to it at all. When I arrived at the airport, I didn't wear like thermals, and oh my god, I was like freezing cold. And even after I checked in and I wanted to go get like food and groceries right with my friend, my body was still adjusting. So although I wore like 6 layers altogether including thermals, I was trembling. Like I was walking and my entire body was shaking. It was so bad. I cried that night. But then by the next morning, I'm like, what did I cry for? It was literally, I think it's just like shock.
For sure. When did you arrive? Which month?
I arrived on the 1st of January. My orientation started on the 3rd of January.
That's early. Too early. My orientation, I think, started on the 15th.
So when did you arrive?
January 10, maybe?
I think it definitely helped that I think on my second day itself, I went to Target and get like bedding and like towels and all that to make myself feel more at home. So that really helped me to settle in.
So they didn't give you pillows, yes, they have, bedding.
In one set, there is one pillow, which is kind of flat because, I mean, it's reused over and over again. And also, like, a very basic blanket, which I didn't feel very sanitary.
Oh, I see, Yeah, they also provided that stuff for us. Mm-hmm. But they were all packaged, so they were all brand new.
That's really nice. We didn't have that luxury.
Yeah, overall, it was very fulfilling, I would say. Like, I did learn a lot more about myself than I did through, like, the textbook. It was very internal, everything that I learned at Ole Miss.
Overall experience was also very good, which actually makes me miss studying there so much.
Yay!
Well, thank you for doing this with me. It was really fun.
Well, that was an abrupt stop. Sorry about that, I didn't plan how to end the video properly. I would like to thank Nicole for being my first guest on this Global UGrad Experience Sharing series. I hope you guys enjoyed not only hearing from me, but also from Nicole. I figured I could spice things up a little bit by inviting my fellow Global UGraders to come on board to share their experience as well, so that you guys, you know, don't get too sick of seeing my face only. Plus, it's always great to have different sides of the story. But do keep in mind that your experience will not be 100% like ours. I always believe in creating your own experience, so yeah, listen to people, but also be ready and be open to create your own experience, your own memories. So yeah, just let me know your thoughts on this video, and if you have any questions, you can always leave it down in the comments section. If you enjoyed watching, give this video a thumbs up before you leave, and do subscribe to this channel for more videos like this one.